Hi, I'm Murray from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Disappear.
What does disappear mean?
Well, it means you can't see something.
To vanish.
Disappear. Can you make anything disappear? Keep listening for the word disappear today on Sesame Street.
Disappear.
That's the word on the street.
Guys,
how are you?
Hi, Big Bird. Hi. Oh, hi there. Welcome to Sesame Street on this great, beautiful... Somebody doesn't sound too happy. Hi there. Is something wrong?
Yes.
Oh. Gee, well, what's the matter?
Nothing.
But you just said that there was something wrong.
It is.
Well, what?
Nothing.
I don't get it.
It's very simple. You see, I'm a zero. The number zero. And that means I'm nothing.
Well, I'm still not sure what you're saying.
Well, maybe you'd understand if I sing about it. Oh. Zero means you've got nothing. And a zero, that's what I am. Let's say you've got three kids. That's one, two, three kids. But then the kids disappear. Oh, you've got zero. Zero means you've got nothing. And a zero, that's what I am. Let's say you've got one duck. Quack. Riding a truck, but quack, the duck and the truck disappear. Oh, you've got zero. A number three, that'd be great by me. Or if I'd been a two, that would do. Even being a one could be fun, but I'm less than one. I am nothing, I'm none, I'm a zero. Just plain old zero. Nobody's zero. Zero means you've got nothing, and a zero, that's what I am. So you see, my dear, oh, I might as well disappear, oh. Then there'd be zero. Zero, zero. Zero, zero. That's my problem, being nothing.
Well, zero, I'm sure being nothing's gotta be good for something.
Like what?
Well, I'm not sure. But hey, I was just on my way to Hooper's store. Maybe Alan can help you. He's really smart. Come on, come on. Come on.
Well, I guess it's better than nothing.
Bye, Alan.
See you later, guys.
Bye. Hey, Alan.
Hey, Big Bird.
Hey, I want you to meet my new friend.
Okay.
Zero.
Zero? You sure I've seen you around? Hey, it's great to meet you.
What's so great about it?
Is something wrong?
Yes, there is.
Well, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Nothing? Well, I thought you just said that something was...
Alan, don't ask. It's very confusing.
Okay, what can I get you guys?
Well, zero?
Well, I guess I could go for a banana split.
One banana split coming right there. Oh, wow, I'm sorry. We're all out of bananas.
You see? He's sorry, because out of bananas means zero bananas, right?
Why do I feel a song coming on? Look, there's zero bananas. which means no bananas today. There's porridge and storage, zucchinis and blinis. There's apples, pineapples, and pears. But there's just zero bananas. There's zero bananas today.
And singing about it won't make me feel better either. Face it, nobody needs a zero.
Well, I do. See, when something's down to zero, I write zero right in hero. Then that zero tells me that it's time to order more. Hello, Susquehanna Banana Company. I'd like to order a big bunch of bananas.
Oh, Susquehanna Banana Delivery from Mr. Hooper's store.
Boy, are you quick.
That's our big appeal.
Now, there's plenty bananas. There's plenty bananas again.
We start out in bunches, and people then munch us at breakfast or snack time or lunch, lunch, lunch.
But now there's plenty bananas.
Sing it with me.
There's plenty bananas again.
I would like one banana, please.
I like two.
All right, here you go. Enjoy it. Steve, there you go.
Thanks.
All right.
I would like a dozen bananas, please, for my mom.
Okay, here you go, Patrice.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
18 for the baseball team.
18, there you go. All right, Chris,
enjoy
it.
Thank
you, Alan. Uh-oh. Again, there's zero bananas. There's zero bananas again. The customers ate them, which means they don't hate them. In fact, they all love them a lot. And now we've got zero bananas. There's zero bananas today, so have a mango. There's zero bananas today, or a papaya. There's zero bananas today. So you see, every time there's zero of something, I know it means that I have to order more. And that's why zero is very important to me.
Well, Zero, you feel better now?
A little, but there's gotta be more to life than being zero bananas.
Oh, don't go. Wait for me, Zero. Oh, boy. This number needs a lot of help.
I sure hope Zero finds something to make him feel good about being nothing.
Yeah, the team is ready! The team ready! Baseball here!
Okay, who's up?
Yeah.
Let's go do this!
Let's see some power on those pitches!
Okay, here we go. Yes, sir!
I know you're trying to help me, Big Bird, but it's no use. I'm just a big nothing.
No, you're not. Well, you are, but, I mean, even nothing's got to be something besides confusing.
Oh, no.
What's the matter, Chris?
I was writing down the score for our baseball game, but I dropped the chalk somewhere.
Oh, gee. Well, who's winning?
Well, nobody yet. The score is 0-0. See, Chris wrote 1-0 here, and now he needs to write another one right here for the blue team.
Yeah, but I can't find my chalk.
Huh? Wait, what? You mean, did you say that you need a zero? Ta-da, look.
Hey, what do you know? A zero.
Yeah.
Boy, are we lucky you're here.
You are?
Yeah, sure. If you stand at our scoreboard right next to this other zero, you'll help us know how many runs each team has.
Yeah, see, Zero? I knew you were good for something besides being zero bananas.
Okay, I'm standing here. Now what?
Well, now you just keep standing there until the score changes.
That's right.
That's it? You mean I don't get to run or cheer or even order a hot dog? How exciting.
Oh, it is. See, look at over there. The bases are loaded, and Alexis is up to bat. So the score could change any second now.
I found my chalk. Okay, batter up.
Holy cow, look at that one. One, two, three, four.
Wow.
Four runs. Yes.
What happened? What happened?
Well, Alexis hit a home run, and the team scored four runs, so I'm writing a four, because the score is now 4-0.
And you helped it happen, Zero.
I did?
You did.
But I haven't even moved.
Yeah. But if you weren't there, we wouldn't know that our team has 0 runs. Oh, no. 0 runs? That means we're losing. It's terrible.
You see, 0s don't make anybody happy.
No, wait. I didn't mean that you're terrible. Maybe we're the ones that aren't so hot, but... There you are, on the scoreboard, a big round 0 saying to us, do better, team. You can do it. Go for it.
Thank you, sir. But it's no use. I've had it with being a 0, and I quit.
What?
From now on, I won't be a number anymore. I'll be a pig. Oink, oink.
Oink. What a cute little piggy.
See? You like me better already.
But 0?
Please, call me babe. Uh-huh. Oink, oink. Snort, snort.
Vasa, we have the problem.
Well, sounds like somebody's in trouble. I better go see if I can help. Good luck with your game.
Wait for your piggy. Oink, oink. Snort, snort.
Sheesh.
There's gotta be another way.
Well, there is not a way. Oh, our moon mission is kaput.
Hey, what's going on here?
If you must know, Nosy Beak, WASA, the Worm Air and Space Agency, was going to send Slimy's friend Glow to the moon because Slimy told her how great it was up there. But now the spaceship can't lift off because the number 0 decided to quit being a number.
Snort, snort.
Oh, snort. Yes, then we needed him.
Wait a minute. You need a 0? Well, he's right
here. Oink, oink.
Hey, stop that. Stop it.
Poor Glow.
Oh, I can just see her in there. Oh, hi, Glow. Uh-oh. She looks very disappointed.
Well, if you ask me, this is much ado about 0. Sorry, Slimy. I'm out of here.
Where you going?
Gee, I just don't get it. What does 0 have to do with launching a spaceship?
Well, you can't launch a spaceship without a countdown.
Oh, yeah, I know what a countdown is. That's when you count all the way down to 0, right?
Yes. We are stuck at 9 because that's when the 0 quit. Vasa Control, we are still stuck at 9. Core Glow!
Didn't you hear that? They're stuck at 9. That's when you quit. Listen, you gotta help them. Come on, 0. You gotta be a 0 again so they can continue the countdown, okay?
The name's Babe. Oink, oink. Oink.
Oh, come on. They need you.
Why would I want to be a 0 again? I was nothing. Now I'm a pig. I can be a contender. Oink.
Oh, but you weren't just nothing. Look at all the things you did today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You helped Alan know that he was out of bananas. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the baseball teams, remember how many runs they had? And now, here's your big chance to send Glow to the moon.
Poor Glow. Oh, 0, why did you disappear?
Well, babe.
All right, I'll do it. Hmm. I shall help send this worm to the moon.
Good for you.
You? A pig? How?
Because I am merely an imposter pig. I really am a 0. Let's start the countdown.
Okay. Wait.
What is it, Slimy? Oh, okay, I'll tell everyone. Okay, you worms and worm lovers out there. Will you help us with the countdown?
Stand by, Vasa.
Here we go, everybody.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
liftoff! Vasa, we have liftoff! 0, you're our hero! Yeah!
Hear that? You're a hero, 0. I'll bet you feel better now.
Yeah, it really is something being nothing.
Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. You mean a lot to me. If you're going for a roller skate, if your hook needs a little bait, if your dog don't wanna sit, or you're sleepy just a little bit, I'll be there most certainly. 'Cause you're important. You're important to me. Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. You mean a lot to me. If your favorite tooth came loose, if you can't open up your juice, if there's no wind for your kite, or your haircut didn't turn out right, I'll be there sure as can be. 'Cause you're important. You're important to me. Important, you're important. Anybody can see. Important, you're important. You mean a lot to me. You mean a lot to me. You mean a lot to me.
Cab Calamouse here with my assistant, the lovely Miss Lady Galanto. Here she is not very distant, but I shall transport her there pronto. There she is, here she is, there she is, here and there she is!
Wow, what a pretty bench! One, two, three, four, five! Five of Elmo's friends! If one, two friends disappear, that leaves one, two, three friends. Oh, and if three more friends disappear, that leaves zero. Zero friends. Great disappearing, everybody.
And now, the fabulous Cap Moe and his friends from Sesame Street.
Yay!
Yay!
On Sesame Street, there's lots of folks to meet, and every one of them can be your friend.
Yeah!
Yeah, there's no need to worry if you're feathered or you're furry. It doesn't matter in the end. You got horns on your head, if you're orange or blue or red, it's so very plain to see. Your sister or your brother, no matter what the color, all one big family. Everybody's got a look.
Everybody's got a look.
Everybody's got a style.
Everybody's got a look.
Everybody's got a try to make everybody feel worthwhile.
Yeah.
Everybody's got a voice.
Everybody's got a look.
Of their very own.
Everybody's got a look.
And when everybody sings, nobody's got to sing alone.
That's true.
Now as you walk around, you hear a special sound, folks saying what they have to say. You might mew or talk, holler, scream, or squawk. Everybody has a different way. Take my word, if you're a monster or a bird, you can't go wrong.
When
you hear a note, take a breath, clear your throat, and start to sing along. Everybody's got a voice.
Everybody's got a voice.
Everybody's got a sing.
Everybody's got a
sing. Everybody's got a honk, howl, rock, ride, and sing. Everybody's got a beat.
Everybody's got a beat.
Everybody's got a beat.
Everybody's got a beat.
Everybody's got a sing. We're singing harmony.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's got a reason for everybody's soul. Everybody got to be yourself everywhere you go.
It's time for action with Traction Jackson.
mind if I play? Hello?
Excuse me, but this is my court.
Well, I don't see your name on it anywhere. Do you, Barney?
I don't know.
Hey! Would you please get out of the way so I can play?
How'd you like to go one-on-one?
Me? Play with you? Don't be silly. You can't play basketball. Not in that thing.
Huh? Hmm.
It's okay, Barney. Oh, yeah? You might be surprised. Unless you're too tired.
You're on. Oh, yeah.
Yes. I win.
Woo. Hey, I'm sorry. You can't play this game.
You're not so bad yourself.
Thanks. I'm Margarita. What's your name?
Tyrone Traxon Jackson. But you can call me TJ. And this is Barney.
Hey there.
Well, we gotta go.
Okay. Same time tomorrow?
You got it.
Oh, hello, it is I, the Count. I'm called the Count because I love to count. That, and I inherited my father's royal title. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, what wonderful number will be the number of the day? It could be anything I play on my wonderful counting organ. Oh, I just love counting numbers. And when I play the organ, the numbers of the day appears. Oh, it's something very special. Because it could be any number, and I can count up to it. Just think of the possibilities. I've been counting the hours for this, you know. Okay, here goes. Hey, what happened to my counting organ? Oh, but I have no counting organ. How can I find out the number of the day without my organ? Hmm? Zero. Wait a second. I have zero organs. Zero. Zero must be the number of the day. Oh, what a wonderful number. Let's see. I have zero organs. I also have zero elephants, zero yo-yos, and zero gefilte fish. Hey, wonderful. I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me. Zero.
Zero Dancer. Zero Dancer. Zero Dancer.
Oh no, what a mess!
What seems to be the problem, my young friend?
I have all of these toys on the floor and my room is a mess.
I think I may have the solution. If you put these toys away in the toy box, then you will have zero toys on the floor. Here, let me show you.
Wow, it looks cleaner already. I'll do the rest. Look, Zero, with my toys all put away, I now have zero toys on the floor. And zero means none. Thanks, Zero.
No problem. Well, my job here is done. Zero the Hero!
Yeah, pretty soon if you do
it.
That's an C7. But you know, if you get a minor chord, then we can do Waltzing Matilda.
But, aren't we gonna do Jump Up?
We could do that one. But I'm just thinking, oh, you know what else is Heart and Soul? We forgot about that.
Zero, three,
Jump up,
Day is breaking, jump up, let's get shaking. I know you're lying down, jump up and we'll dance around. Jump up, bells are ringing and I hear friends are singing. Oh yeah, it's a crazy sound. Jump up and we'll dance around. Jump up, stand on your tiptoes, reach out, grab a rainbow, turn it upside down. Jump up and we'll dance around. Jump up, clouds are passing. Look up, sky is laughing and I know we'll be laughing too. Jump up,
I wanna dance with you.
Mystical pigeon whisperer whispered mystically to the pigeon, coo coo.
Come on, buddy! It's time to dance!
What? What? Annie? What's going on? What are all these monsters doing here?
I think it's the funky chicken, Bert.
The what?
Come on, Bert, get up and dance!
No, I'm reading, Ernie. Hey, get out, everybody!
Oh, come on, buddy, Bert. Don't be a wallflower. Be a waltzflower!
What? I just want to read my book, Ernie.
Oh, you can read later, Bert. It's time to dance now.
No, no dancing, no dancing. Just everybody leave.
Come on,
please.
Bert. It takes two to tango.
What?
Yes.
Please depart, everyone. What are you doing now? The tango? Oh, what's going on here? Ernie!
That never happened.
When you were a baby, you were so very sweet, cooing and a crying and playing with your feet. But now you are a big kid, and look what you can do now. You can skip down the path with the wind in your hair. You can pedal your bike past the old stone bear. You can feed your pet and make it so merry. You can fix a snack of yogurt and berries. You can draw fantastic birds with colors so bright. You can brush your teeth in the morning and night. You can name the dinosaurs that roamed the earth long ago. You can write your name with letters that you know. You're a big kid now. Think of all that you can do each and every day. You're doing something new.
Y'all live in the capital, I...
Oh, hi! I am drawing a portrait of the letter I. Yep, that's right. It's for my forthcoming One Bear Show, Baby Bear. A bear and his letter. Hey, it's Abby Cadabby.
What is that?
Oh, this is the letter I. Yeah, as in... ice cream.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Where'd you get it?
No, Abby, I didn't get it. No, I made it myself. Yeah, with this wee little crayon.
Oh, you did?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, could I make the letter I? Oh, could I, huh?
Yeah, sure, Abby, here, take the
okay.
crayon. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Let me give you a nice clean sheet of paper.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, the letter I.
Mm-hmm.
Toe of toad, eye of fly, let there be the letter I. Kazam!
Abby?
Kazoo!
Abby, that's not a one.
This eye's not working very well.
Yeah,
kaboom!
No,
kabam!
Abby?
Ka-something!
Oh, Guado, Abby! That's not how a crayon works!
Well, how does a crayon work?
Well, here, I'll show you. Here, come over here.
Okay.
Now you just put the point of the crayon onto the paper. And now you press, and you move it in a straight line.
It's making a red line.
Yep. That's what a red crayon does.
It's magic.
Mm-hmm. Now you go, and you draw a line right across the top, like this.
Oh.
And now you go to the bottom, and you draw a line across the bottom, like this. That's okay. That's all right. There it is. Look at this. You just drew the letter Y.
Oh, it's so enchanting.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait till I tell the elves about crayons. They'll never believe it.
You know, come to think of it, it is magic.
Now it's time for American I, the show where contestants compete to see who is the best letter I. And here is our American I host, Prairie Dawn.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Good evening, everyone. I am Prairie Dawn, and welcome to American I. Tonight, we are going to choose the best letter I in America with the help of our judges, Rosita!
Oh, Prairie Dawn, thank you! Thank you! I am so, so happy to be here!
Oscar the Grouch!
Yeah, well, I'm not happy to be here.
And Dog the Dog!
Oh!
Our first contestant comes all the way from an alphabet in Biloxi!
Yes, but I always wanted to be the letter I ever since I was in the alphabet.
Okay, here she is.
Baby, 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 baby.
Yeah! Ooh. Okay, judges, what do you think?
You're definitely not the letter I, but you tried your best, and you really made it your own. I'm so proud of you, and I think you should be the next American I.
Woo! What? What? But she's not the letter I. Oscar, surely you don't think she's the American I?
She's not even close. That's why she should be the American I.
But Oscar, that makes no sense.
Yeah.
Dog, what about you?
Oh,
you think she should be the American I? But she's the letter B. Wait. You can go now. Before you decide, we have another contestant. Come on out.
Right you are, Mum. But I have been taking letter I lessons ever since I was a lowercase letter.
Okay. Take it away.
Whoa, 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 W.
Okay, judges. What do you think?
That really touched me right here. I am so proud of you. You really made it your own. And I think you should be the next American I.
I'll say, why, you're nothing like the letter I.
But he can't be the American I. I mean, just look at him. He's the letter W. All right. Our last contestant is from an alphabet in Iowa. Yes! Yes, 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 yes! Finally, it's the letter I! Please, I, do your thing!
ask me, she's not the American Eye. She's perfect. Too perfect.
Oh, I don't believe this! How about you, dog? You've got to be kidding! What's wrong with you, judges? This is the letter I! Just look at it! It should be the American Eye! Do you hear me? I! Okay, Mom, okay. Okay, we have our winner.
Who?
You!
Me?
But I'm not the letter I. I mean, I'm not even a letter.
That's what makes it so right.
And you sound just like the letter I. I'm so proud of you, Prairie Dawn.
Really? Oh, I'm the American I. I never dreamed this could happen.
Please. Susie Kabloozy is about to sing a hymn. Sing! Sing a song. Sing out loud. Sing out strong. Sing of good things. Not bad. Sing of happy. Not sad. Sing. Sing a song, make it simple, to last your whole life long. Don't worry if it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Sing, sing a song. Sing a song!
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. Elmo loves his goldfish, his crayon too.
Yeah.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
No.
Don't blow into a banana.
That's not what you do with a banana.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
What is he doing? Yeah, what does he need a paper for?
What is that?
A lamp.
A lamp? What does he need a lamp for?
I don't know.
No.
What is he doing?
No.
No.
No. If you don't write with a banana, it's not a pen. That's not what you do with a banana.
No.
You peel it.
And you eat it.
It's not something you dip in ink and then write.
That's it, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, good, Mr. Noodle.
Where'd the banana go, Mr. Noodle?
Oh, Dorothy thinks maybe we should ask someone else. What do you do with a banana?
You eat it!
Dorothy wants to know how.
Dorothy, this is how I eat a banana. I love bananas. Dorothy, this is how you eat a banana. Dorothy, this is how you eat a banana. First, you go like this and take the other side and pull it down. And you take the other side and pull it down again. And you take the other side and pull it down and you eat it.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. What do you do with a banana? There you go. Yeah! Thank you, baby! And now, Elmo has a question for you! How many bananas are on this hat? Let's count them and see. Just one. Banana they put it in the oven. Careful. While the bread was baking, they took some plantains. Oh, that's another type of banana. Michael's favorite. And they fried them. While the plantains were frying and the bread was baking, they made banana pancakes full of chunks of bananas. Of course. Ooh, they look good. Yum, yum. Then, for something to drink, they made banana smoothies made with milk and what else? Bananas. Then, for dessert, they made banana pudding topped with slices of bananas. Banana bread, fried plantains, banana pancakes, banana smoothies, and banana pudding. And they all look so yummy, they invited Michael's friends over for a banana feast. Yay! Thanks to apples. No, I was just kidding. Bananas! And that's how Elmo's friend Michael had a banana meal. Now Elmo wants to find out even more about bananas. How can Elmo find out more? Yeah, that's right. Elmo can watch the Banana Channel. Good idea, TV.
The Banana Channel. Programming with appeal.
And now, the story of bananas.
Bananas are fruits that come in bunches.
Enjoy a banana, it's a very fine fruit.
People eat them at breakfast and they munch them at their lunches.
Boy, a banana is a very fine fruit.
There's no meal of banana who won't fit into.
Chew on a banana, it's a very fine fruit.
It's the very best fruit that I ever bit into. Will it grow outside your igloo?
Unfortunately not.
People eat them cooked and people eat them raw.
It's a treat, a banana. It's a very fine fruit.
All around the world, it's the fruit that people gnaw.
Can't be beat, a banana. It's a very fine fruit.
You can slice it on your cereal. So nutritious. Or bake it in banana bread. Mmm, delicious. So put one in your lunch. The pocket of your suit.
Ooh, yeah.
And when you eat it, you'll agree that
and it's a very fine fruit.
Coming up next, a bunch of other stuff.
Don't you? How can we learn more?
Here comes a banana.
Who is
I'm
that?
The top banana. Here comes a banana. I'm the top banana.
Talk to me, kid. Thank you.
Are you a banana?
Am I a banana? Kid, I'm the top banana. Thank you.
Because Emma wants to know more about bananas.
Kid, you know more about bananas than you think. Thank you.
Really?
Absolutely. Like, what do you call this yellow part? On my outside. Thank you.
That's the peel. The peel.
Right. Thank you. And what do you call this part? On the inside. Thank you.
Well, that's the fruit. Yeah, the part that you eat.
That's right. And it's good for you. And we're healthy. And that's it. Thank you. Kid, you know enough about bananas to be a banana. Thank you.
Oh, look. Look, Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a banana in a banana tree. Thank you.
Yeah, kid. Bananas grow on trees in hot places. Thank you.
Yes, it is. Daylight come at me. Ah! Oh, no, no, monkey. Almost not a banana. Almost.
You can also find bananas in a supermarket in the fruit section. Thank you.
Ted, you're it.
What? Oh, banana Ted. Yay! Monkey, where are you? Elmo's gonna find you. Oh, there you are. Come back here, monkey. That was fun.
Hey, kid, did you ever see a banana split? Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Well, you're about to see one split again. Thank you. Stay away, monkey.
Elmo has one more question about bananas. Can a banana peel itself? What do you think? Well, Elmo made a video with Dad's camera. Yeah, it's called Can a Banana Peel Itself? By Elmo. TV! Oh, there you are. Go ahead. No, bananas can't peel themselves. Oh, thanks, TV. Bye-bye. Thank you. Boy, Elmo really loves bananas. Oh, so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the banana song. Yay! Here we go.
Goodbye.
To read Marco a bedtime story.
Uh-huh. Well, I can't really read yet, but my mommy reads it to me all the time, so I know it by heart. Yeah. So if you just turn the pages, I'll pretend that I'm reading to little Marco.
Perfect. Sounds good to me.
Okay.
And the name of the story is?
Real People Tales.
Real People Tales.
Yeah.
Good one. Okay.
Okay, there we go. Once there was a boy named Scooter whose daddy worked at a computer. They had no magic wands or fairy wings. Thank you, thank you. But they were really great on the swings. His dad would push him up so high that Scooter felt like he could fly. That's real magic.
All right, it sure is.
Good job. Look, I think little Marco loves Real People Tales. Yeah, and you know what else, Marco? Sesame Street was brought to you by the letter I and the number 0.
Good job.